All right, we got to do it. We got to check the pulse of Steeler Nation now.
Oh.
As the Steelers have been sneaking into the playoffs, we've been checking the pulse of Steeler Nation, and Steeler Nation has been excited.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hey, why not us, right?
Uh-huh.
Then they go to Buffalo and lose.
Yeah.
So let's do what we've been doing as we snuck into the playoffs. Now that we're out, let's check the pulse of Steeler Nation.
Okay, how many times do we have to physically assault Mason Rudolph?
Oh, no.
Like, come on. The dude's trying. He's a good quarterback. He's a great quarterback. How many times do we have to physically assault them? Keep Mason. Keep Cam. Keep TJ. Keep Minka. Keep Porter. Keep Jalen. Fire the rest of them.
Oh,
get
wow.
A whole new team.
Oh, wait. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on one second. A whole new team?
That's
oh,
your turn.
There's like... Wait.
Yeah, I wasn't ready for that.
We keep like five people, but the entire team, everybody else, you're out.
I thought that was gonna be like a nice cuddly message. Be nice to Mason. You know, they weren't that bad.
Yeah.
The team played okay. Everybody's gone.
They're like five of you can stay. TJ, Cam, Minka, PZ Jr. You can. Everybody else, get the hell out. You know what? We gotta do it. Oh, damn! Send everybody except like five people to the crossroads. Get them out of here.
Woo.
Never winning a Super Bowl with this team.
Didn't even see that coming.
And a minimum Steeler football. And a minimum Steeler football. So there we go. The pulse of Steeler Nation says, like, keep like five people, but everybody else, you're gone. Now, the Steelers edited the end of the Coach Tomlin press conference from their social media and their website because I believe it's Brooke Pryor from ESPN asks one final question after it's asked, you know, any more. So this is after Coach Tomlin was only answering questions for a couple minutes, and then Brooke Pryor asks about, you know, his future, and he just walks off.
Anyone?
Mike, you have a year left on your contract.
And he's gone. He's just gone. That's, you know, anyone. So it's the end of the press conference.
He's still standing at the podium, like, waiting for a question.
Yeah.
He heard the start of that and then just tucked his head and shot off to the side.
Not looking to answer questions about whether he'll be back, whether he's going to retire, whether he wants to leave Pittsburgh.
Anyone?
Mike, you have a year left on your contract.
Yeah. It's not a great look. I understand probably why the Steelers edited that out. I don't know. Like, everybody's trying to do their job. I know it's,
dude just lost, of course, fired up, probably disappointed, but...
You could say something like, not now.
Right. You just got to answer the question. You can't just duck your head and run away.
Yeah, it's just not a great look, especially since it's Brooke Pryor, and I feel like there's a history of him dismissing her questions, and I don't know. We got to do it. We got to get through this sludge of Steelers Facebook comments. I want to see what's in there.
There's plenty going on in those comments. All there's plenty.
We got two rounds of Steelers Facebook comments today, around 7:10 and 9:10 here on the Kiss Morning Freak Show. It's Mikey and Bob. Let's get to this message.
Hey guys, well, we didn't win,
but
you know what, that's okay, because like we said, it was an extra week of football.
It was bonus football. We didn't win the Super Bowl, we didn't win a playoff game, but we got an extra week of football. That was kind of fun
that we absolutely didn't think we were going to get at the beginning of the season.
Yeah.
And it was an awesome week of shows, getting all hyped up for the game.
Yeah.
And everybody coming together with Steeler pride.
Yeah, it was fun.
And regardless of the outcome of the game, I think, my personal opinion, that Mason has proved himself to at least be the backup for next season, if not fight for the first position.
Oh.
But that's just me. Love you guys.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see what happens with the Steelers quarterback situation now. Is it just back to Kenny Pickett? Man, think about when Kenny Pickett left this team. He's watching Mitch Trubisky lose to a couple two-loss teams. Put yourself in the mind of Kenny Pickett. He has to be thinking, if I would have been healthy, we would have beat those two-loss teams. I could have finished the season like Mason did with winning. Kenny Pickett probably thinks that the Steelers could have been like one of the top seeds in the AFC and maybe even...
Under him, yeah.
Yes, that's what I'm saying. Like, so a lot of people from what Mason Rudolph did, though, when he got in there, are thinking like, well, he might be the starter next year. He could be the backup. Mason Rudolph was asked after the game, you know, does he want to come back?
I have no idea what's going to happen. I mean, none of us in there know what's going to happen tomorrow, much less next year. So I'm still thinking about the game and the loss, and it hurts and it stings. And
yeah.
We probably could have done better today. I think the turnovers early, myself included, didn't really give us the ability to put our best foot forward. So that's what's on the forefront of the mind right now.
Mason Rudolph has sort of an interesting offseason coming up because he proved he could play quarterback in the NFL,
mm-hmm.
right?
Yep.
He proved that because he was the third string. He was about to start going into real estate. But now I think he's a viable backup quarterback in the NFL. And plus, no team would sign him this offseason. He stuck with the Steelers because nobody
else
was going to sign him, even though I think that situation has probably changed now. He was asked, is he even willing to come back?
Yeah, I love the Pittsburgh Steelers. They've been my only home for 6 years. We'll see what happens. Like I said, it's not really my decision. A lot of it's out of my control. We'll see what happens.
No, it kind of is your decision, though.
It's going to cost him. That's what he should have said.
Yeah.
They're going to have to pay me this time.
He's like, the price just went up on Mason Rudolph as your backup quarterback. You can send us messages through the free iHeartRadio app. Just hit the talkback microphone when you're streaming the station or our Mikey and Bob podcast. All right. The fancy man guy wants to send us a message here, Bob.
Mikey and Bob, unfortunately, every battle can be victorious.
Yeah.
But let's take a moment to thank the Pittsburgh Steelers for the season that we did have.
Yeah, that's right. A nice run there, Steelers. Seriously, I thought you were going to be 7-10 this year. Thanks for a little tickle of the playoffs.
The offseason provides opportunity for growth and rebirth.
Yeah.
Next year, they'll rise like a phoenix and be better than ever.
Yeah.
Wow.
But in the meantime.
In the meantime?
How about a little Let's Go Pens?
Oh, how about a little Let's Go Pens?
How about a Let's Go Pens.
Hey, it's like the Penguins knew that we were going to need them, right? Let's just jump right into the Facebook comments. The Steelers go to Buffalo and lose 31-17. That is five straight playoff losses for the Steelers. And then we went to the Steelers Facebook comments section.
Beware.
Oh, no.
We are going to a very deep, dark place on the internet. Everyone is a GM.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Everyone is a coach. Everyone is going to get traded.
Everything sucks.
It's time for Steelers Facebook comments.
Steelers lose in Buffalo 31-17. That's five straight playoff losses. We will get into the Steelers Facebook comments here with JS. Let me be the first to post it, even though I know everyone else is going to post the same thing. Fire Mike Tomlin. Oh, damn! There he is. We got to get it out of the way, right? We got to get it out of the way.
Let me be the first to post it.
Send him to the crossroads. He's gone and never coming back.
First one ever to post it.
Need a new coach.
Oh, God.
And I'm going to miss Coach Tomlin. And I'm going to miss Coach Tomlin. Donnie G here in the Steelers Facebook comments. That field looked perfectly fine. Nice of the league to move the game a day and fix that game so Buffalo would win. Probably all to get Taylor Swift there next week for TV ratings. That's right. The game was rigged.
It was all planned.
The game was rigged against the Steelers because of Taylor Swift.
Bring Taylor
is where we're at.
Buffalo.
Frank M. I've been watching the Steelers for over 50 years. All right, Frank.
Hell yeah, Frank.
How aren't you coaching now,
Hell
Frank?
Hell yeah, Frank.
The credentials are out. Frank M., been watching Steelers for over 50 years, and Noel and Cowher are two coaches that would have had their teams eating lightning and crapping fire going into a playoff game. The Steelers look and play like a JV team under Tomlin. He has to go. Oh, damn! Coach Tomlin doesn't have the players eating enough lightning and crapping enough fire.
I want to see those players crap fire.
There he goes. And I'm going to miss Coach Tomlin. And I'm going to miss Coach Tomlin. Listen, wouldn't it be amazing if this week Mr. Rooney sat Coach Tomlin down and said, Mike, listen, we don't get rid of coaches a lot, but I've checked the players' pants.
There's no singe marks.
They need to be crapping more fire here, Mike. Steelers Facebook comments after they lose to the Bills. Stan B. Dump Mike I almost called him Mike Clownlin.
Mike Clownlin.
A little slip there, I guess. Dump Mike Tomlin. He sucks as Steelers head coach.
Okay.
Bring back Bill Cowher. Oh, if Bill Cowher was the coach, Pittsburgh would have won. It's true.
How many? 70? Cowher's been gone a long time.
They never lost under Bill Cowher, though. All the six Super Bowls were under Cowher. They made it to the Super Bowl every year under Cowher. Every single person was happy in this city when Cowher was the coach. Oh, everything was good. Did Coach Cowher ever have a disappointing playoff loss?
Obviously
not. Did he ever, not win the Super Bowl? Because it feels like he won it every year.
Every year.
Like, I look at the scoreboard. Cowher's got one. Tomlin's got one. It's about even, right?
Yeah, that's not the real scoreboard. Yeah. Cowher won every year.
Yeah, he won with Tomlin's players, or Cowher's players, though. Cowher players.
Jeff L. in the Steelers Facebook comments. Got a bunch of couch coaches in these Facebook comments. Y'all kiss my black and gold ass. All right, so there's a no fair weather in this comment there.
Coming through.
Jared J., Mason Rudolph is not Big Ben. Kenny Pickett is not going to be another Big Ben. Okay. Time to move on from both of these quarterbacks. Oh, damn! There goes the quarterbacks now.
They're not Big Ben.
I don't know who's... Wait. We can't be keeping Mitch Trubisky, though, right? Is he the only one left?
He didn't say anything about Mitch.
All right, there goes the quarterbacks.
Mitch is Big Ben?
Edelman is the quarterbacks. Ryan B. wasted my damn day off watching that horrible Steelers game. You owe me a day off work, Steelers. Listen, the Steelers social team, they need to put out like a printout.
The little note.
Yeah, that's like, dear employer.
Please excuse Jerry.
Yeah, give this Steeler fan an extra day off work. They had to watch our playoff game, and it put them in a really bad spot. And we will end this round with Jeff W. I watched the first quarter, and then I had to pull out Terry Bongshaw to smoke a little, took a little nap, and enjoyed the rest of my day. All right, not Terry Bradshaw. He pulled out
Terry Bongshaw.
Terry Bongshaw just smoked myself into a nap. The NFL playoffs, the next round is all set now after the two games yesterday. Of course, Steelers losing in Buffalo 31-17. And then last night, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers beat the Philadelphia Eagles 32-9 Monday Night Football down in Tampa. So this weekend of football, you got Texans at Ravens on Saturday and Packers at Niners on Saturday. And then Sunday, it's Buccaneers at the Detroit Lions. And then it all ends Sunday, 6:30, the final game of the weekend, Chiefs at Bills. I believe that's the first time that their quarterback, the Chiefs quarterback, Patrick Mahomes, is going to be playing a road playoff game. So Taylor Swift in Buffalo?
On the road?
On Sunday night. We'll see how that works out for them. But, yeah, Steelers are out now. It kind of sucks. And obviously a lot of questions now, as there is every offseason, on who's going to be back. Is anybody going to just step away? Is Coach Tomlin going to be back? Does he even want to coach anymore? Obviously he was asked about that with the last question during his post-game press conference and didn't want to hear it and just walked off.
Anyone?
Mike, you have a year left on your contract.
And he's gone. That's fine. If he doesn't want to talk about that now, it's fine. It's a little rude,
probably,
but it's fine.
Probably just said, not now.
But the Steelers also edited that part off of the press conference video from their website.
Which is weird.
Why would you do that? Because
really weird.
Then you're saying, we don't want people. We all saw it. Why would you delete that from the site? He did it. He walked off. It happened. But no, scrub it from the site. Yeah, we're not going to be able to find that on the internet or anything like that. It's weird, right?
Yeah.
Let's talk about Cam Hayward, though. Cam Hayward was asked, he had a rough season, man. He was injured a lot, and he was asked about the season and his future after the game.
It's been a rough season.
Do you expect to be back?
Hold on. I got to get the music right. Cam Hayward, he's like Pittsburgh's sitcom dad.
Yeah.
He always has a lesson. All right, let's get the sitcom dad music for Cam here on the rough season and his future.
It's been a rough season.
Do you expect to be back?
In my heart, I want to play. But, it's been rough. I need to take the offseason to get healthy again. Battling back through a groin. It's one thing to just walk off a groin.
Walk off a groin.
Another thing to play football. And there's been some other stuff, but it's definitely been a season that I just wanted to put my hand in that pile.
All right, he just wanted to put his hand in that pile.
Wanted to be there for the team.
Tough to walk off a groin, though.
Yeah.
Here was Cam Hayward talking about getting older and really not wanting to play for anyone else.
I'm a year older. You look at this game, and the average is 3 years. I beat it every time.
Oh, man, he's so sitcom dad Cam right now, right?
Sad with the sitcom dad music.
I know.
But, coming off some injuries during the season, it was a testament to even get to the playoffs.
Yeah.
We battled all year long.
Yeah.
I don't really pay attention to what the coaching thing is because I feel like Mike T is going to be back. But that's not my decision. I'm not going to speak for him. I just know I think the group here collectively is a strong group that can win a Super Bowl.
All right, so Cam is saying he's not making any decisions on obviously the future of Coach Tomlin, but he feels like he's going to be back as coach. Obviously, this hurts losing in the playoffs like this. Cam Hayward was asked about, you know, does he have the desire to do this all again for a shot at a Super Bowl?
I have a lot of desire for that. That's the thing that bugs me the most that night, you know, not having an opportunity to win a Super Bowl. Seeing all my teammates before that have won it, seeing the culture and the tradition here, every man should feel that way. It stings, you know, to be out of the playoffs, to not have a chance to continue to move on. Man,
yeah.
I'm not ready to give that up.
Oh, man. Oh man.
Sitcom dad, Cam, we love you, man.
Steelers dad there.
Oh, man.
Having to talk.
Listen, I hope. We got one more thing left that we can win here. I really hope that this is the year for all his work he's done for our community. I really hope that Cam Hayward wins NFL Man of the Year this year. That would be pretty cool. It's not like a playoff win. It's not like a Super Bowl, but that would be pretty cool because that dude is so loved by everybody in Pittsburgh and has done so much great work in our community. Salute to you, Cam Hayward, man. I hope he continues to play because
hope he gets another chance.
He's actually playing at a really high level. It's not like he's just the old guy that's bringing the rest of the team down. It's like, no, soon as they knew Cam wasn't in there, they were running the ball last night.
I'm like, just talking about like not winning the Super Bowl. It's what keeps me up at night.
I know, right? Oh, it makes you smile. Even though they lost, we're all kind of down. Makes you smile that Cam might not be done yet. Well, let's get to this message.
Here we go.
Oh, no.
Steelers.
Oh, no.
Here we go.
Oh, yeah.
We had a hot Rudolph.
We did.
Here we go.
We had a hot Rudolph. I mean, like, Mason Rudolph wasn't horrible, right?
No.
I would say he's still kind of a smoldering, lukewarm Mason Rudolph, right?
I'm not
a hot Rudolph anymore, though. He's been cooled down.
Like, going into that game, I convinced myself Steelers could win.
Me too.
And then I watched the game, and, you know, they scored that first touchdown, and fans started throwing snow in the air, and I'm just like, oh, no.
Oh, no, yeah.
Like, oh, no.
Two touchdowns by the Bills to tight fans ends in the first quarter.
Fans just throwing snow up as, like, plays are happening. It was awesome.
It is.
And then they still weren't out of it, though.
And then Josh Allen, their quarterback, ran for that touchdown. Yeah, and then you're like, okay, we're probably about...
It hurt my heart.
Probably about done here. Coach Tomlin, after the game, you know, said nothing mystical about why they lost.
I'm appreciative of the efforts, but it's not mystical. We didn't do what was required to win tonight. We didn't take care of the ball. We didn't get the ball from them enough in an environment like this, and thus the score.
You know what it is? You can't make splash plays because splash is what happens when you jump into water, right? Splash.
Yeah.
The splash was frozen.
Oh, my goodness.
That's it. And the NFL
figured it out.
And the NFL rigged that, by the way. The NFL
they froze
that.
The Steelers
that,
splash?
They did. Yeah. Steelers had splash, right?
Man, you're
defense
right.
Defense was making turnovers. Mason wasn't turning over the ball. They froze our splash is what they did. Coach Tomlin was asked if not having T.J. Watt was, you know, the big factor in why they lost.
You know, I didn't think about it, to be quite honest with you. We knew all week he wasn't playing, and so we prepared with that mindset.
Yeah.
And so I didn't waste any time thinking about what wasn't at our disposal.
Yeah, so obviously it would have helped with T.J. Watt, but no, I don't think the game was decided by having T.J. Watt in there or not. Coach Tomlin was also asked about Mason Rudolph and how he played, especially down the stretch, getting us into the playoffs.
I thought he was solid. I thought he was competitive. I thought his confidence was unshakable. I thought he, you know, displayed the things that he displayed really for the last month or so.
Oh, man. That sounds like a guy who's going to be back.
It sounds like a guy who's going to be back,
sounds
right?
Sounds like a guy who's going to be back, probably, right?
Does Mason even want to come back, though?
I don't know.
I don't know if Mason wants to come back.
Millions of dollars change everything, though.
Yeah, but yeah. There's probably another team that's going to pay him a little bit more than maybe the Steelers want to play.
True.
Because, listen, there's probably a team who said, hey, that Mason Rudolph not that bad over there. When we're like, oh, yeah, okay. Yeah, okay. Yeah, he's serviceable, right? Maybe he'll be our backup next year. I don't know.
Probably never wants to sit at number three again and not dress.
No. And then, of course, the last question was the walk-off. There was, you know, the room was asked if there's any more questions, and I believe it's Brooke Pryor from ESPN who's got one more question for Coach Tomlin about his future.
Anyone?
Mike, you have a year left on your contract.
He's gone.
He gone.
Now, Coach Tomlin is probably annoyed by all of the rumors that he might not want to coach anymore and might want to just step away from, you know, being a head coach in the NFL altogether. So he's probably already sick of the talk about him not being back as Steelers head coach.
Not a crazy question.
No,
it's not.
It's not.
He went through all the game crap,
yeah.
Talked about everything else. Any more questions? Yeah, Mike. 1 year left, what, you know, and then he just walks off.
Yeah. All in all, this is kind of a fun season, right? I actually thought they were going to be about 7-10. I thought this was going to be a losing season. I did not think they were going to make the playoffs.
Got a little bonus football here.
We made the playoffs with a third string quarterback
then
leading the charge at the end.
Convinced myself they could win.
Yeah, then we started.
Made myself believe.
Once they got into that playoffs, we were thinking like, oh, man.
They let us in.
Now they kicked us out. They let us in, and then they kicked us out. All right, we got another round of Steelers Facebook comments coming up. We started the show this morning by checking the pulse of Steeler Nation after the 31-17 loss in Buffalo.
Keep Mason. Keep Cam. Keep TJ. Keep Minka. Keep Porter. Keep Jalen. Fire the rest of them.
Oh.
Get a whole new team.
There it is. There's the pulse of Steeler Nation this morning. Basically, fire everybody but about a handful of people.
Couple keeps. There it's gone.
And get a whole new team. Let's hear from Najee Harris, right? He came on late in the season, threw up some 100-yard games, didn't have the numbers in Buffalo, obviously. Steelers were playing from behind for a lot of the game. I think but Najee is making some headlines after because he's calling for changes. Now, when you say changes, I think that usually means coaching changes or just an overall team attitude change. I don't really know what Najee is asking for here because the headline's going to be Najee Harris, you know, calls for change after Steelers eliminated. But here's what he said after the game.
I've been here 3 years, obviously. It's my third year. You know, I have my opinions on things, but I'm just a player. But, you know, if we want to elevate, get where we're at, we have the chance to make house stuff.
All right, so he's saying he's been here for 3 years, but if they want
I'm
to elevate,
a player.
Got to change some stuff.
Yeah. Najee, just so we don't take your comments out of context here, you know, what are you alluding to? What do you mean when you say things have to change?
Like in-house rules.
In-house rules, he said. So he's not talking about, like, Coach Tomlin or anything, and he'll clarify that later, but he's saying in-house rules need to change, okay?
Like not no changes around coach like that. It's just the rules that are in the building that...
All right, so not coaches, just change the rules that are in the building.
You know, we got to be more disciplined. We got to be more committed. You know, I'm not saying that we're not, but, you know, just coming from a place.
All right, well, you can't say we've got to be more committed and then in the next sentence say, I'm not saying that we aren't, right?
Yeah.
That has structure. And just seeing, like, you know, we probably could get help in these areas. It might make a change. I think that's something we could help. I'm not saying nothing about coaches or anything like that. I'm just saying more of just in-house rules.
All right, so he's saying in-house rules need to change. What is he even, like, talking about there? Like, are players having too much fun and he doesn't like it? Now, again, he came from Alabama and playing for Nick Saban in the football factory down there. So maybe after 3 years, he's like, this ain't like Alabama here. Players sort of can do what they want and have free reign, and there's not enough discipline around here. Is that what he's sort of saying? Or is he saying they need to get rid of the ping pong table, remember?
Right, yeah, like, it's bizarre, right?
What are the in-house rules that need to change? Because usually when a team gets eliminated from the playoffs, it's like, you know...
Coaching changes.
Yeah, things like that.
Somebody goes, yeah.
George Pickens decided to rip on the referees. He'll probably get fined for that. He blamed it on the refs. Okay, I get
there might be a couple bad calls here and there. The refs did not lose that game.
Is Nodge talking about the Steeler way?
Oh, man.
Is that what he's bringing up?
You think he knows the Steeler way after 3 years?
It sounds like he's talking about knowing the Steeler way.
Oh, man, you're right.
The rest of the guys aren't following along.
Oh, man, you're right. No.
Nothing to do with the coaches. This is just the Steeler way.
You can't say everybody doesn't. Like, Cam and TJ, they know the Steeler way, right? I think not. You're right. I think Nodge is saying only guys who know the Steeler way can be around here now, right?
Maybe if you go back to maybe trade everybody except for the guys that know Steeler way. Maybe that first message that we got to start out the morning.
Do you think that's what it was? Do you think this is it? Maybe are these the people that know the Steeler way? Joey Porter Jr., he knows the Steeler way. He's been around his whole life.
Keep Mason. Keep Cam. Keep TJ. Keep Minka. Keep Porter. Keep Jalen. Fire the rest of them.
Wow.
Get a whole new team.
Steeler way. Bring in people who only know the Steeler way. Hey, there is some breaking NFL news this morning. It's about the Philadelphia Eagles, which, of course, they lost last night down in Tampa. And I think we wouldn't care about this if Taylor Swift wasn't directly involved with the Kelce family, right? Like, I think that's why any Kelce brothers news is like, everybody cares about it now, right? Jason Kelce, 6-time All-Pro, future Hall of Fame center.
I mean, just host of the most popular podcast that's out right now.
Yeah, the New Heights, the New Heights podcast with his brother Travis, obviously dating Taylor Swift, told his teammates in the locker room last night that he is retiring. He was visibly emotional. At the end of the game last night, Eagles lost down in Tampa 32-9. Says he's been considering retiring after other seasons, but this time it's supposed to be real and supposed to be happening. I think when you tell your entire team when it's been, you've been thinking about it for a couple years, when you tell your whole team after a playoff loss, like, hey, thanks for the ride, but this is it. Also, it doesn't hurt that he has, like, the number one sports podcast in the country, basically, to fall back on his brother who is dating one of the most famous humans on earth. But hey, does this mean that he finally gets to spend time with Taylor Swift? Like, Jason Kelce's going to be in the booth, right?
He's got
to
go.
He's got to go support his brother now, right?
Put him in the box. Were they at Buffalo? Yeah, they're at Buffalo. Put him in the box.
Yeah, it's the first road playoff game for Patrick Mahomes. So all those Bills fans, man, that were braving the elements to go see the Bills beat the damn Steelers, they'll be at it again. It's the final game of this upcoming weekend, the Sunday 6:30 start. It'll be Chiefs at Bills. You would think that Taylor Swift will be going to see Travis, probably sitting in a suite with Mama Kelce, and now it looks like possibly Jason Kelce. Jason Kelce also might not want to go to Buffalo after his season just ended. I feel like I'd want to take my family on vacation despite my brother playing in the playoffs. I'd be like, yeah, that's great and everything. I do not want to go to Buffalo right now, though.
It's like football, maybe not this weekend.
Yeah, maybe I'm retired now. I'm going on a big family vacation to somewhere warm. But I don't know, though. You get to sit in the suite with Taylor. I think he probably goes to Buffalo, but we'll see. But Jason Kelce retiring from the Philadelphia Eagles after they lost last night down in Tampa. Let's get to this.
Well, boys, you can officially make fun of me. I'm sitting in the living room.
Mm-hmm.
Game ends.
Yep.
I'm bawling my eyes out. My man walks in. He's like, what's wrong? I'm like, I just wanted Mason to win the game. He's such a good quarterback. I was literally crying for Mason Rudolph. Never thought I'd ever be here as a Steelers fan. But I was literally bawling my eyes out Mason Rudolph didn't get to go to the Super Bowl.
Yeah, no. You weren't sad for anybody else? It was just Mason Rudolph tears?
Just Mason?
Yeah, it's, Mason Rudolph, he wasn't horrible, right? Like, he wasn't horrible. He can be the back. Is he the backup now?
Sadder for a guy like Cam, though, that's been through this for so many years and hasn't had a chance to play on,
Oh, man, I just don't want it to be over now. I don't want it to be over.
It's over. It is over,
my
friend.
I don't want to start thinking about, like, players that might go, and I don't want to start thinking about the draft and, quarterbacks and all. I don't want to think about all this right now, man. We got plenty of time
trust me, we are going to milk the Steelers content for all it's worth, right? Got to, right?
Coaching changes.
Oh, man.
The Steelers lose 31-17 in Buffalo. Fifth straight playoff loss. And then we check the Steelers' Facebook comment section.
Beware.
Uh-oh.
We are going to a very deep, dark place on the internet.
Well,
everyone is a GM.
Everyone's a coach. Yeah. Everyone's going to get traded.
Everything sucks. It's time for Steelers Facebook comments.
Steelers Facebook comments after they lose to the Bills in the playoffs. John G.
Coach Bill Cowher needs to stop picking us to win these damn playoff games. He always picks the Steelers to win, and it's like he gives us a Cowher curse every time. Whoa.
Is there a Cowher curse?
Frank M., pretenders for a decade, zero championship culture on this squad.
Oh, watch out.
Tomlin's gotta go. Damn! No surprise, we got fans that want Tomlin gone.
He's gone.
Send him to the crossroads.
That's it.
Never coming back. There he goes. And I'm gonna miss Coach Tomlin. And I'm gonna miss Coach Tomlin. Brennan T. here in the Steelers Facebook comments. The NFL is a rigged league, plain and simple. Right. I love the Steelers. I'll always root for them.
I'm
done watching this stupid scripted league. And for the people saying, what about the injuries? Are those fake? Listen, WWE has injuries, and it's still fake and scripted. The NFL is labeled an entertainment league, not a sports league.
Oh, man.
Which means they are allowed to rig and script games. It's also why they're allowed to partner with the sports books.
Wow. Broke the code there, obviously. Secrets out.
Too much to even handle there. Moving on to Derek W. Time to regroup. Time for a reboot. Time for a new direction. Simply put, time for change. Time to get rid of Tomlin. Hire Mike McCarthy. If he leaves Dallas, he's got Pittsburgh grit you ain't going to find anywhere else.
Hell yeah.
Man, where's the grit at? Oh, man.
Is that Derek Watt, by the way? Derek Watt? Do we know?
Might be Derek Watt.
Bring
in the comments. He might think it's his way back on the team because he's got grit, too. Kimberly H. in the Steelers Facebook comments. I hope this is Tomlin's last game as Steelers coach. I love my black and gold, but I'm done.
Damn!
There he goes, man. Coach Tomlin has been fired so many times this morning.
Wow.
We've actually lost count.
Yeah.
Going to the crossroads, never coming back.
Just living there.
And I'm going to miss Coach Tomlin. And I'm going to miss Coach Tomlin. Don P. in the Steelers Facebook comments. Whole thing stinks, but hey, at least we got the Pirates and Penguins to look forward to. All right, Don.
All right, Don. A little positive energy there.
Shine that turd if you want.
Yeah.
Rocky M. Steelers never had a chance. The league and Vegas fix this game just like they do with NASCAR, the UFC, and WWE. I am done watching the NFL. Damn! Man, freed up your...
It's all fixed.
Freed up your Thursdays.
Not watching NASCAR.
Freed up your Sundays.
WWE or UFC.
Freed up your Mondays.
Screw you, NFL.
It's rigged. And I'm going to miss watching football. And I'm going to miss watching football. Got a couple more here. Bill B., Mr. Rooney should give Steelers GM Omar Khan a broom and let him clean house.
Okay.
Bring in new coaches, draft a QB, and let Big Ben coach. Steve D.
Snuck that in.
Once again, our dear leader, Mike Tomlin, has crapped the bed. Oh, did he crap the bed in Buffalo?
I didn't know that.
Check the sheets. Josh R., bring in ex-Bill Cowher players as coaches now to install culture, change, and discipline.
Bring back Cowher's players.
It's been Tomlin's way for too long. All right, they're too old to play now, so
we got to bring back
bring
the players.
Coaches.
Yeah, coaches.
Bert S., our offense is crap. Our quarterbacks are crap. Coach Tomlin's crap. Defense is crap. The punter's crap. Mr. Rooney's crap. Another crappy offseason. Man, Bert.
It's a lot of crap, Bert.
Settle down, man. Brian G. in the Facebook comments here. If our punter is on the team next year, the entire coaching staff and personnel department will be guilty of incompetence, and I will turn over my season tickets. Okay.
Over the punter?
over the it's a lot. It's a lot to get that upset about.
Season
the punter,
ticket holder, 33 years. They're going back next year if that punter's on the field.
Presley Harvin didn't have a great game.
I mean, it wasn't great, but yeah, you ain't gonna turn your tickets in.
Nah,
we're just lying in these Facebook comments.
We're all upset. You wanna end on a good note though?
Let's end on a good note here.
Right. Steelers Facebook comments. Sherry S.
Sherry.
Still my team.
Hell yeah.
Still my Steelers.
Hell yeah.
They call me Steel City Sherry at the clubhouse down here in Florida. Been a fan since the 70s. I just hope I don't die before they win that seventh ring.
Oh, God. Took a morbid turn at the end there.
You know what, man? I don't care what we got to do. I don't care who's quarterback. I don't care who's head coach. But damn it, Steelers, you got to win for Steel City Sherry.
Careful there.
Steel City Sherry.
Almost was a completely different thing.
Almost ended our show there. Steel City Sherry at the clubhouse down in Florida needs number 7. Well, before she dies, I'm getting up there. But whatever, got a good weekend of football.
The real MVP yesterday was that Yinzer dad that walked the whole row. Good. Just one man plowing in his Rod Woodson jersey.
Chris Adamski from the trip got that video. It looked like from the press box as three Steeler fans. It looks like a husband, wife, and a child is what it looked like, right? And they are, you're right, the row is full of snow. You've probably already seen the video. And this guy is just moving his legs and trucking through.
Dad can't be stopped.
The snow that's just like waist deep. And he's wearing a Rod Woodson jersey, I believe, too, right?
Steeler should have put that guy a linebacker after seeing that pregame performance.
You're right.
He's got a couple plays in him.
That guy should
stop a run.
He should have been in the game at some point.
That leg drive?
Oh, yeah.
He can stop a run.
Get Rod Woodson dad out there. Look at those legs pumping.
Josh Allen up the middle, not on his watch.
Josh Allen ain't hitting that, 50-yard run or whatever it was in the end zone. Not with that guy, man. He's keeping his knees high in
one
that
man's
jersey.
One man plow.
One man plow. All right. We'll see what happens now with the offseason, but either way, we don't get to decide who's coaching or who's playing next year, so just enjoy whatever this offseason brings because none of us really get to affect it at all.
However, we will milk that Steelers content.
Yeah, can't wait, man. Can't wait for offseason and draft time now. And yeah, still some football to be played. And the Super Bowl always gives us good content. Can't wait for Super Bowl halftime show, Facebook comments, and we still got some things to look forward to from this NFL season. Man, kind of sad we don't. Oh, man, if they would have won, it would have been Ravens week.
Oh,
we would have been going to
God.
Baltimore. Man, this city will be on fire if they would have won. Oh.
Just showed up today and just go, they let us in.
Oh, man, we won.
Rudolph's hot.
Oh, man.
Ravens don't want any of this.
I love how we're ending the show just acting like, what if they would have won? You're right. It would have been Ravens week. But instead, you know how Taylor Swift, made a couple of sadder, I would say, slower albums, Folklore and Evermore. Mm-hmm. And then she would do a song, but put like, Sad Girl Autumn version. And it would just be like the saddest acoustic version. That, but the Roger Wood Here We Go song.
Yeah. Yeah.
Here we go.
Yeah. This is
man.
The eliminated from the playoffs version.
Oh, no.
Here we go.
We're not going.
Pittsburgh's going to the Super Bowl. Here we go.
Nah, it's over.